So before we look at how to convert any of this design over to a template, let's start by looking at what HTML is and how it works. So I'm going to jump to my File Explorer, and I'm going to expand the Part 1 Steps folder here. And I'm going to copy this first step, which is 01index.html, simple HTML. And then I'm going to go to an empty folder. It doesn't really matter where it is on your system, and I'll paste it in. And I'll rename this index.html, which is just removing the first part and the last part from the file name. For this series, we're going to use the Chrome browser in order to preview our files. So I'm going to drag this over to Chrome, and it will open it. And you can see that we have some content displaying in the browser window. Now let's open up the file and see what's actually inside. So now you can open up this HTML file in a text editor. On a Mac, you can use Text Edit. On Windows, you can use Notepad. But you'll get a bit more mileage if you can use an IDE, which is called an Integrated Development Environment. And I'll show you why in just a moment. So the IDE that I'm going to use is called Phpstorm. So here's that file. You can see the same text that we saw in the browser, heading in the right direction. And also, if there's only one of me, why am I called a pair a graph? And because we're opening this up in an IDE instead of just a text editor, we get something called syntax highlighting. You can see that the H1 here is a dark purple, as well as the closing H1 here. Same with the P and the P here. So this just gives us some visual cues as to what's going on in the code. Now, HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. So it's not actually considered code because there's no logic inside of it. Instead, it's markup. It's just a way to convey some additional information besides the text. Even though it's markup and not technically code, you'll still hear it referred to as HTML code sometimes. And what we're doing specifically with HTML is we're telling the browser exactly what these pieces of content mean. And typically, there's an opening tag and a closing tag. So you can see the H1 tag right here. H1 means heading 1, which is the first level of heading. So we could have heading 2, which would be H2, heading 3, which would be H3. The opening tag uses a left-angled bracket and a right-angled bracket. And the closing tag is the same as the opening tag, except there's a forward slash at the beginning of the tag name after the opening bracket. And you can see that same structure here. For the P tag, which means paragraph, you can see the closing bracket right here, which just includes the forward slash. So all we're doing with this is saying, hey browser, this is the heading, and this is a paragraph. And let's look at it in the browser again. So I'm going to jump over to Chrome, and you can see here's the heading right here, and here's the paragraph.